this is Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com, and we're at the end of February. We're getting ready to think about planting our garden, but it's too early yet. You can see out the window, there's still snow on the ground, but it's not too late, or too early rather, to start planting things indoors. So if you have a garden that you would like to have cool weather crops in, you can start those right now indoors. Things like broccoli, cauliflower, kale, and spinach, they can all be started right now. Then you have to be a little calm about it, but about 6 weeks, 7 weeks before the actual last frost date, which in Wisconsin is in Milwaukee area, it's about May 15th. So about 6-7 weeks before that, you can start planting things like tomatoes and green peppers. Then you have to hold off, be calm, and you have to wait until about 3 or 4 weeks before the last frost before you plant things like squash. Anything in the squash realm, like cucumbers, pumpkins, all those sorts of things, you have to hold off until very close to the last frost date. Now you can just plant all of these things outside at that point, but if you plant them indoors, you have the space, you have enough light, you can give them a head start. So when you get them out there, they're ready to go and they will produce sooner. So today, I'm going to be planting some spinach. This is called America spinach. And when you're looking for seeds, that's another thing. When you're looking to buy seeds, look to see when it's what year and what date it's supposed to be made for. Like if you look at it and it says packed for, it'll say what year. This says 2013, thank goodness. If you go to some places where maybe they are trying to get rid of old seeds, you could be fooled. So just keep an eye open for that sort of thing.
Well, it doesn't mean they won't grow. No. It just means that, you know, maybe less...
They're not as fresh.
Well, or you won't get as many to propagate.
You won't get as many, right.
Yeah.
So you'd have to plant more. And it's not a bad thing. You just have to plant more of them to get a good germination. So I'm planting spinach, and I'm planting this very strange Italian broccoli. I've never seen this growing before. We've never tasted it, but it's supposed to be interesting. It is a burpee product, but I'm going to try it. It's from their international collection.
So you're going to be planting all these indoors right now?
I am. And not all of them. I'm going to save some of them. I'm only going to plant enough that I can put in these containers. And then as they grow, I'll be able to spread them out more.
Well, I could spread the snow out and you could start planting out in the garden.
Now, if you do have a cold frame, you could actually move them outdoors sooner. It's a little cool. Today, although, with the sun shining, it is, I believe, 66 in my cold frame. But it went down to 20-something last night, so that wouldn't work. All right, so the first thing I'm going to look at is this broccoli. And while it's not teeny, tiny, teeny, it's small enough. I'm going to plant maybe half of those. So I'm just going to spread them out, and it's going to be hard to see because they look like the earth. I'm going to spread them as much as I can. Trying not to get them right on top of each other. This probably is way too many for here. I think I'll put some back. If I like them, I want to plant some more outside when the time gets right. Okay, and then I'll take a little more earth, about a quarter of an inch, and just sprinkle that on top, making sure that there's contact between the seed and the soil.
Now, the soil that you're using, you mix that soil...
This was a mixture of planting soil and some
vermiculite
in there. And I believe we had a little bit of peat, and I believe we also put in some worm castings. So it should be very delicious for those seeds. And then don't forget to put your marker in so you know what they are. Okay, same thing with the spinach. Spinach seeds are a little larger, and they're lighter in color, so you can see them better. Now, I haven't had a whole lot of luck with my spinach. When I had it in the greenhouse in the fall, it just didn't produce the way I had hoped it would. And then, unfortunately, it got aphids on it from that parsley I brought in, so both the parsley and the spinach had to go. Okay, put my soil on top. Pat it down a little bit. You don't want to compact it. You just want to pat it down just so you know that there's good contact. Oop, and here's some sticking out over here. Okay. Put my marker in. And then you gently want to water these. You want to water them thoroughly. I have this tiny little sprinkling can that we found in the children's department, which is actually perfect. Now, if I were doing this on a bigger scale, obviously, I'd need a bigger pot. But this is perfect. Look at that. Okay. On top of that goes the plastic wrap. This will keep not only the moisture in, but also the heat. And they do like to be warm so they can germinate. And you'll notice that actual raindrops of moisture will form on the top of this once the sun starts shining. These will be under a grow lamp, so it'll actually be artificial sun. Then as the sprouts start, then I'll take more popsicle sticks and actually lift up the plastic wrap so that the wrap and the plants don't come into contact with each other.
So I suppose next you're going to want me to make little hoops for your indoor garden, just
would
like we did
I
for the outdoor.
Would I want that sort of thing?
I think so.
Well, you only need it for a short time, because once they have sprouted and start growing, they easily take up the water without having to have their own little greenhouse. Now, I was thinking, what else could I be planting at this time of year that would be fun, wouldn't take up much space, but it would be something fun you could do with a child and show them where plants actually come from. And the easiest one I can think of is a piece of citrus fruit, like a lemon. Lemon seeds, in the past, at least I've found, are easy to sprout, and then you can plant them and the children can see how they grow. But we also sometimes have vegetables that like to sprout before you get to them. Now, this is a rutabaga. It comes with a wax coating because they like to sprout. You can see this one is starting to sprout right there. They coat them with wax to inhibit sprouting. Well, I waited too long on this one, and it just went to town and started sprouting around the whole top. I had the same thing happen with my turnip. So when I was trimming it, I just trimmed off the whole top that was sprouting, and I put it in just a little cover from a butter container. And I was wondering what would happen if it would actually grow roots on it. Will it actually develop into a plant? What will happen? This one's getting a little mushy there at the bottom, so I'm anxious to get it in the ground. Okay, so I'm just going to set this in. I'm going to move the dirt around it soil, excuse me. And then I will water it. Again, water it in very well. Now, this is a pot here that I was growing lettuce in. Well, the lettuce is done. And if I were planting new seeds in here, I would get rid of this soil, put it in my garden, my compost, and start all over. But since it's just an experiment with something that probably we won't be eating, it won't actually turn into a plant that we'll use, I'm using my old soil up. Now for this lemon, I'm going to cut it open. Undoubtedly there'll be some seeds in there. There always are. And I'll probably, make a liar out of me. There we go. See that nice, nice full seed. This one I've nicked and it's all wrinkly, so that probably wouldn't be a good candidate. But anything that is full, nice and swollen, dig around in there. This is something fun to do with kids. They'll see where plants come from. I remember as a child growing an orange tree. Didn't get very big, but it was fun watching it and imagining that it could grow oranges in our house. I think that was as many as I'm going to get. This is surprising. Okay, so I have, let's say I have five here. Okay, so then I'm going to just take a piece of paper toweling. I'm going to put them on the paper toweling, not right next to each other. Where'd it go? Okay, and then I'm just going to move it here. Then you're going to wet the paper toweling. Okay. You'll be able to see that the seeds are in there. Works even better if you don't have a little pattern on your paper toweling. And then put it in a plastic bag. And that's all you need to do. Then you're going to put this, you could put it on the kitchen counter, someplace where it'll be warm, not hot, and where the sun isn't actually going to shine on it. And within a couple of weeks, you should be seeing little sprouts coming off. One side will be a root, and the other side will be a little green sprout. And once they get to that point, you want to take them, put them in a little pot, and start with a little pot, and plant them in some soil. And they should grow into a little tree for you. It's fun. It's free. You've already purchased the fruit, and it'll be fun for your kids to see. Another little hint, if you want marigolds, this is where you always had this saying in school when we were trying to think of something to make for Mother's Day. On the St. Patrick's Day, plant your marigold seeds and they'll be ready by Mother's Day. So that's another thing you can plant indoors. Marigold flowers love to grow. They're tough, they're hardy. So St. Patrick's Day, marigolds ready for Mother's Day. Bye for now. Hope you enjoyed it. Give us a thumbs up, subscribe to us, we'd love to have you, and leave a comment anytime. See you soon.